Now that the main concepts are covered, use blended box mapping to texture an uneven terrain. Uneven terrains can be difficult to map by their very nature, especially when imported from third-party applications. Often, their topology adds to the difficulty, and unwrapping can then become a nightmare. It's not exactly the case in this scene, named BBM Terrain Start.max, where the terrain was in fact modeled in 3ds Max. Still, the geometry of this particular terrain is still complex enough that traditional mapping techniques would be difficult. In case you're wondering, this terrain was built in 3ds Max using a simple plane object and freeform tools such as push-pull, shift, and relax. It is all made of one mesh, except for the two smaller boulders in the center left. Those started as spherified boxes and then shaped into boulders with the same tools used to shape the terrain. Select all three objects and apply a standard material to them. Add a blended box map to the diffuse channel and test render the scene. The default setup is already a good starting point. From there, you can test the solution using a checkered pattern to look for bad texture stretching. You could use the default checkered procedural map or use your own bitmaps. I personally prefer that method as I can fine-tune the solution to look for problems in projection directions. When loading bitmaps, naming convention plays a big role. Bitmaps sharing the same name with appropriate suffixes can be loaded more easily. In this case, all three bitmaps start with the name checker and end with front, left, or top. By using load maps, you can select any one of them, and all three would be used in the appropriate slots. Blended box map tries to conform to the shape and size of the model it is applied to. It stretches to accommodate the size of the object. By default, blended box map is applied in a non-uniform way. This means that the scale of the map is not the same between smaller and larger objects. You can control the map size at the individual bitmap level or at a more global level in the blended box map controls. Set the map scale to 10 to see the effect on the terrain and boulders. You can see that the map size on the boulders is different from the terrain. You can manage these situations using the projection controls group. If your bitmaps are square, like typical tiling maps are, you may want to enable the cube option to avoid texture stretching. Moreover, the pull-down menu lets you choose how the projections behave. In the default non-uniform mode, each object gets its own virtual mapping gizmo based on the size of that object. This is why the texture scale is different between smaller and larger objects. Set the general map scale to 100 once again to test the other options. You can force the same uniform map size onto all objects by defining it. Set it to 5. And test render the scene. The checkered patterns are now uniform throughout the scene. You can also use a picked reference object in the scene to define the map size based on that object's size, or you can base the map scale on the largest object in the scene sharing this material, which in this case means the terrain. For now, go back to the non-uniform size option and ensure the global map scale is set to 100. Another way of controlling the projected maps is to treat various objects as one, using the multiple object at once option. This lets you create a projection box in the form of a dummy object that you can transform in the scene to control the mapping. This can be based on selected objects or on all objects sharing that material. As mentioned earlier, you may also simply want to work the bitmap sizes at the bitmap levels. This is the approach I personally favor. When you're done experimenting, go back to individual objects mapping type with a uniform mapping size of 100%. Render at this time shows that the map scale is rather huge, if uniform. Simply edit the individual checker patterns to make them tile 20 times in each direction. Render again. With the global scale set to 100%, the test renders look quite satisfactory. Once you're happy with the projections, you can start replacing the checker patterns with actual textures. A few were provided with the scene, most notably textures for grass, dirt, and rocks. The rock wall image is straightforward and meant to be used for X and Y projections. The grass and dirt textures are meant to be used for Z projections, perhaps mixed up with the help of a noise map. This can be done by using a mix map with the dirt and grass textures, add a noise map to act as a mask. You'll probably need to fiddle with the noise map a bit to get it to work to your liking. A finished scene is also available as part of the downloadable archive. In the next movie, we take a look at the animation limitations associated with the blended box map.